there's been some great moments in these series between these two teams, but that one in 2000 kind of sticks out because it is the longest game in modern NHL history. What do you remember most about it, Paul?
Well, I remember Ron Tugnutt was unbelievable for the Penguins. They were firing pucks at him, and he was just a little guy, and he just rose up and played a phenomenal series, and he had an incredible game that night. I don't remember how many saves it was, but it was an absurd number. Unfortunately, he didn't make that one on Keith Primeau, but what I remember was I was doing the game on the radio, and I actually felt lightheaded after, I think it was after the third overtime. And I had to go get a Coke and get some sugar in me because I actually thought I was going to pass out. I'm not kidding. And because it just kept going and going and going. And I had never been involved in a game like that where I was actually calling the game. I did color with Mike Lang during a quadruple overtime game before, but not a quintuple overtime game. But what I remember was that Primeau actually made a nice play. He had something left in the tank because he came down and made a nice move to cut to the inside and shoot it over Tugnutt's shoulder. And we were pretty amazed at that because it seemed like nobody should have that kind of energy at that point. But he found that energy somewhere enough to score the winning goal.
Is that one of those special moments, even though it went against the Penguins and in the favor of Philly, that you just kind of remember? And did you walk away as a broadcaster and say, I'm glad I was a part of that in some small way?
Yeah, I mean, it was a fun thing to be a part of. I think we were disappointed. You know, when you lose a game like that, even though it didn't decide the series, you sort of had a feeling at the time that it was something that was going to be a bad omen for the Penguins in the series, and it turned out to be the case. If you remember, the Penguins took a lead in that series. They were up 2-0 in Philadelphia, and it turned the other way. And that was really the turning point. I think if the Penguins would have won that game instead of the Flyers, they would have won that series. But as it turned out, Keith Primeau's goal was sort of a harbinger of the fact that the Penguins were going to lose.
These series since then have been like that, where there's that one game. I guess you could say that about any playoff series, but really between these teams, you can look at one game and go, well, they won the series 4-2, but really they won the series maybe back in game 3 or 4.
There's really a lot of turning points, a lot of things that happen during the course of a series, any series that are key moments. I mean, I remember in the series in 2009, Marc-Andre Fleury made an unbelievable save on Jeff Carter. If Carter scores there, maybe the Flyers win that series and the Penguins don't win the Cup. So, and you go back to 91, same thing. Laurie Boschman in game 6 in New Jersey, scores a goal off his skate. As it turned out, he actually did put a stick on it, score the goal. They said he kicked it in, but today, if they had replay, they would have shown that he actually did score the goal, and maybe the Penguins don't beat the Devils in the first round and go on and win the Cup. So it happens every year, and it will happen in this series too.